Hello friends, welcome to this video lecture on centroid, which is a part of subject engineering mechanics. So in this particular video, we will be going to discuss what is centroid and how to locate the centroid of any body or any area or any composite lamina. Now before studying what is centroid, let us first discuss what is center of gravity. As we know that the center of gravity is nothing but it is one point at which the weight of the body acts in vertically downward direction, which is called as center of gravity of a body. Now to understand this, let us take one example of a body. Now as we know that the body consists of number of small elemental particles. So all these small elemental particles will be having some weights, and these weight will be acting in vertically downward direction. So if we find the resultant of all these small elemental weights, then we can represent it by a total weight, that is W. So we can say that this is the total weight of a body. Now we assume that this total weight of the body is supposed to be concentrating at a single point of a body. This point is nothing but is called as center of gravity of a body. Now let us see how to locate the center of gravity of any body. So for that we have taken one example of a plate having its thickness is uniform. Now for example, the weight of this plate is W acting in downward direction. Now suppose this point G is nothing but the center of gravity of this plate. Now to locate the center of gravity, we have taken its Frick's frame of reference, that is X, Y and Z axis, and from this X and Y we can locate its center of gravity like X bar and Y bar. Now we are interested first to find out this X bar and Y bar. So for that, we can divide this plate into some small elemental plates. So we can say that this plate consists of number of small elements having their weights as delta W1, delta W2 and so on. So their respective distances from X and Y axis, we can show them as X1, X2, X3. And so on, or y1, y2, y3 and so on. So now we are interested to find this X bar and Y bar. Now we can say that the total weight of this plate is nothing but sum of all the weight of the small element. So we can say here this total weight W as delta W1 plus delta W2 and so on. So now to locate this X bar and Y bar, we can use the concept of Varignon's theorem. As Varignon's theorem says that moment of resultant about an axis will be equal to sum of moments of all the forces about the same axis. Means in this case, we can apply this Varignon's theorem about X axis, also about Y axis. So first we'll apply this Varignon's theorem about Y axis. So when we are applying this Varignon's theorem about Y axis, we can say that moment of this total weight W, means moment of the resultant weight of this body about Y axis, will be equal to sum of moments of all the small elemental weights about the same axis, that is Y axis. So by taking moment of all the forces and moment of resultant about Y axis, we get this equation. So by taking summation of moment about Y axis, on left hand side we'll get moment of this W about Y axis, that is W into X bar. So on left hand side we can see here it is X bar into W. So on right hand side we'll have moments of all the small elemental weights about the same axis. So here we can say it is X1 into delta W1 plus X2 into delta W2 and so on. So we can take the moments of all the small elemental weights about the same axis. Now similarly, we can take moment about X axis now. Now when we are taking moment about X axis, once again we have to take moment of this weight about X axis. So here on left hand side we can see it is Y bar into W, and on right hand side this is sum of moments of all the small elemental weights about X axis. So if we use these two equations, we can easily locate this distance X bar and Y bar. Means ultimately we can locate the center of gravity of this plate. Now let us see how to convert this center of gravity into a centroid, or basically what is the difference between center of gravity and centroid. Now in case of a flat homogeneous plate of uniform thickness, the magnitude delta W of the weight of an element of the plate can be expressed as delta W is equal to gamma into T into delta A, where gamma is the specific weight, or it is weight per unit volume of the material, T is the thickness of the plate, and delta A is the area of the element. So by multiplying the specific weight to the volume of this plate, that is T into delta A, we get the total weight of this element of this plate, or small element of the plate. Similarly, we can express the magnitude W of the weight of the entire plate, means total weight of the plate, like this, that is W is equal to gamma into T into A. So now, if we put that formula of total weight and weight of the small elemental plate in this, so we'll get this equation of movement, that is x bar into A is equal to x1 into delta A1 plus x2 into delta A2 plus so on xn delta An. Similarly, we can put this in equation of movement about x axis, that so you will get y bar into A is equal to y1 into delta A1 plus y2 into delta A2 and so on plus yn into delta An. So ultimately, we can convert the plate into a this area. Now here we can see, now we have neglected the z axis. So here, instead of a plate having some thickness, we are neglecting its thickness. So here we have an area. Now here, this is the position of the center of gravity, whose distance from y axis is x bar and from x axis is y bar. So now we can again calculate this x bar and y bar by above these two formulae. And here, in general, we get the equation of this x bar A as summation of x into delta A. Means what? The movement of this area about y axis and about x axis will be equal to sum of movements of all the small elemental areas about x and y axis. So same thing we have to do here in this case. To locate this x bar and y bar of this total area, we need to divide this total area into small elemental areas. And then we have to take their movements about x and y axis to get these equations, that is x bar A into summation of x into delta A and y bar A into summation of y into delta A. Now here in this case, as we have neglected the third dimension, now here in this case, if we see this point C, we can see this, it is a geometric center of this body. So here we can define the centroid. It is nothing but the geometric center of the area or plane lamina, then we say that it is a centroid. So this is the difference between the center of gravity and centroid. So we can define here centroid as it is a geometrical center of plane areas. Now in some regular shapes like a rectangle or a triangle or a circle or a semicircle, we can easily locate the positions of the centroid. Now these are the centroids of some common shapes like a triangle, a circle, semicircle, quarter circle, or ellipse, or semi-elliptical area, or a parabolic area, semi-parabolic area. Now these are some standard formulae for some regular shapes. Now let us see how to locate the centroid of any composite area. Now for example, we have this composite area. It is having zero thickness, means its thickness is negligible, and in this case it is having only area. So here we have considered x and y axis. Now for example, this C stands for this position of the centroid of this composite area, whose distance from y axis is x bar and whose distance from x axis is y bar. Now we are interested to find this x bar and y bar. So as we discussed that, to locate the centroid of such composite area, first of all you need to divide this area into again some small elemental areas. Now here we are not going to convert it into small elemental areas, but here we are converting this into some regular areas. So here in this next diagram, you can now see whatever is the total area or a composite area, we have divided into again some regular areas. So here if you see now the first part, that is area A1. So here we have this triangle. Second part we have that is one rectangle, and third part we have that is again a triangle. Now we know the centroid of this triangle, centroid of this triangle, or centroid of this rectangle. Now again by applying the same formula which we used, that is moment about y and moment about x. So here first it is moment about y. So here it is x bar into a will be equal to, in this case, x1 into delta a1 plus x2 into delta a2 plus x3 into delta a3. Here we have only three areas. So here you can restrict this only up to x3 into delta a3. Now instead of delta a1, delta l2 and delta a3, you can directly take here a1, a2 and a3, means area of this triangle, area of this rectangle, and once again area of this triangle. Now you know this x1, x2, x3 distances, means centroidal distance of these areas from y-axis, and further we need their distances from x-axis. So if you see now here, we can get this x bar by dividing this total equation on right hand side by total area of this area of this given composite shape. So here in this case now, the right hand side of this equation, the right hand side of this equation, it is called as first moment of area. It is called as first moment of area. So to locate the centroid, we can say that if we divide the first moment of area of a given area or of a given composite lamina, we can just divide it by the total area. So we can easily locate the centroid, that is here, it is distance x bar. Now similarly, we can use the equation about moment about x axis. So here we have y bar into a will be equal to y1 into delta a1 plus y2 into delta a2 plus plus so on yn into delta an. So here again, instead of this, we can put here a1, a2 and a3. Here we have only three areas, and again we have to take the moment about x axis. So here we will be getting finally y bar will be equal to a1 y1 plus a2 y2 plus a3 y3 upon a1 plus a2 plus a3. Now again, if you observe the right hand side of this equation, it is the first moment of area. We can say it is the first moment of area about x axis. So we need to just divide this first moment of area by the total area here, that is a1 plus a2 plus a3. We can easily locate the centroid from x axis. So in this way, we can locate the centroid of this composite lamina about x axis and about y axis. So finally, we'll be getting this x bar and y bar. Thank you.